Hi, good morning everyone. So today we'll be getting into the syllogism. This is very important. Get 2 marks. So we are going to have 2 marks question from this. So from 3 years we are getting questions based on this. Before we get into this, I think you people know about this. There are 3 relations which are to be known here. All, some, no. These are the 3 relations which you should be knowing. So all is nothing but, suppose you will be representing like this. How you are going to represent, I will tell you again. So it means that this is A, this is B, you think. So all A or B. All A or B. So all A should be B. From this can I say that some B are A? Only some part of B is A, but all parts of A is B. Okay, all A or B. All means we should be representing like this. Some means, so some A or B. So some part of A is B, some part of B is A. So some means we will be representing like this. Some A or B or some B or A. Even this also can be taken. Some B or A. Okay, so next. So no incident. No B is A. This is A, this is B. This is no B is A. So no B is A means, so there should not be any relation. No B is A. So we should not have any relation between this and this. I mean this and this. So all A or B means every part of A should be inside B. Some A or B or some B or A. So some part of A should be B, some part of B should be A. So no A or B means we should not have any relation between A and B. See here this can be told as this also. Some B or A also can be written. So there are many ways in which we can represent a syllogism diagram, Venn diagram. But this is an alternative for this. Some B or A, this can be told, no, some B or A. This is an alternative. We will be having alternative diagrams. You remember this. When we go for negative case or possibility, I will be telling you about alternative case. But as of now, you remember that all means every part of A should be inside B. Some means both should be having intersection like this. No means we should not include any part. Okay, copy this. Hope everyone is getting that. So we have a case of sum not. I'll explain that sum not case in the problems again for you. If I tell you as of now, you'll get confused. I'll explain that in case of problems for you again. Next. See here, questions based on syllogism. Deductions or syllogism are solved using Venn diagram. There is another way also, but I don't recommend that for gate examination. Venn diagram case will be simple for us. To answer these questions, one should have a thorough understanding of the words like all, some, no, some not. So the some not, when I come for the problems, I'll explain you, etc. And one should also know how to represent them in Venn diagrams. Okay, this is what we have seen. In these questions, two, three or four statements are followed by certain conclusions. Like earlier, yesterday when we saw inequalities, no, we have seen conclusions. We should tell whether that conclusion is following or not. Statements will be given. From the statements, we should draw whether the conclusion given is following or not. Okay, so conclusions given, one has to find the conclusion that definitely follows the given statement. So each of these questions, now coming to the directions, each of these questions consists of 2 statements followed by 2 conclusions marked 1 and 2. Consider the following statements to be true. See, again I am telling you, when you see in syllogism, all pens are Katz Hilton. You should not question that, like a scientist, you should not question me that, sir, how can pens become cats like that? So you should think whatever is given in the question, that is true. Okay, you might tell that some rats are Bats Hilton. Okay, you should assume that some rats are bats. You should not go for the scientific view. You should not think of the practical view. So whatever given in the question is true, you should assume. Then only you can solve this. Okay, that is what is given. So even though they see here, consider the statements to be true, even though they seem to be at variance with the commonly known facts, and find out which of the following given conclusion logically follows. So sometimes he might tell which doesn't follow. Also, you might ask. Okay, generally in other competitive exams, you'll be asking which generally doesn't follow also. But see here, we are seeing which follows. Okay, follows a statement disregarding the commonly known facts. Mark your answers as one follows, two follows, either one or two follows, neither one or two follows, if both follows. Okay, so we should be telling whether the conclusions are following or not. So if they are following, which is following and which is not following, we should be telling. Okay, next. So we'll see simple questions initially. So all C's are B's. So before this, I want to tell you one small point. So I hope you copied this. I want you people to just see the logics here. See. Suppose this is A, this is B, C, D, E. See, I want you people to tell the relation between A, from A to everyone, we should tell the relation. So now from A with respect to B, I mean A, with respect to A, I am telling all A are B. Am I correct? All A are B. Next. Next, all, so, or else, see here, now from A to C, is there any link between A and C? We don't have any link between A and C, no? So, no A is C. Next, A and D also we don't have any link, no A is D. Now, A and E also we don't have any relation, A is E, no A is E. So now with respect to B, you try to tell. So from B, if I see some B are A, am I correct? Some B are A. Some part of B is A, no? Some B are A. Next. What about B and C? Some B are C. Some B are C. In the same way, some B are D. Some B are D. Next. Similarly, now from B to E, we don't have any relation between B and E. So, no B is E. No B is E. Now, with respect to C, so if you go for C, so is there any relation between A and C? No, no. So, no C is A. No C is A. Next, with respect to B, so some C are B. Next, with respect to D, every part of C is inside D, no? So, all C is D. Next, with respect to E, there is no relation between C and E. So, no C is E. Okay, next. Coming to D. So, we want to tell the relation between D and other terms, no? Is there any relation between D and A? No, no. So, no D is A. No D is A. Next, between B and D, some B are D. Some B are D. Next. Next, between D and C, some part of C is occupied by D. Okay. So now, some D are C. Next. Some D are E. That's it. Some D are E. So remember that. So, this is A, this is B, this is C, you think. When you come from inside, it is all. So, when you come from inside, all A are B, all A are C, next all B are C. When you come from inside, it is all. When you go inside, from outside, when you are going inside, it will become some. Okay. So, now some C are B, some C are A. Some B are A. So when you come from inside, it is all. When you go from outside to inside, it is some. Okay? Just copy this. So just for practicing purpose, copy this.
Ketana is saying, sir, voice is overlapping. I think everything is fine. Here it is fine, everything. Next. So next we will see simple question initially. All C's are B's, she told. So all C's are B's. Am I representing correctly? Next, some T's are B's. So some T's are B's. Okay. So now this is a statement diagram. Now we should see whether these conclusions are following this diagram or not. So now this is all T's are C's. All T's are C's. There is no relation between C's and T's itself. See, here I want to tell you one thing. So this can be drawn like this also. C's, B's. Some B's are T's means you can draw like this also. Okay. So, but what I want to tell you is that there are many alternative diagrams. When you check number of alternative diagrams, it will take lot of time for you to solve the questions. So what I want to do is, don't bring the unnecessary relations in this logical diagram, Venn diagram. So whatever is given in this, try to mention those only. See, here he told all C's are B's. So we took this. Next, some T's are B's, he told. He told only relation between B and T. But if you represent here, no, this is also correct. Some T's are B's. But see here, you are representing with the C's also. So when you bring unnecessary relations, you should check all the alternative diagrams. If any one alternative diagram doesn't satisfy the, if any one conclusion doesn't follow one of the alternative diagrams, then we should say that it is false. So instead of checking all those alternative diagrams, what I do is, I don't want you people to go for unnecessary relations which are not given in the statements. Whatever is given in the statement, for those only you try to represent. Okay. So now all T's are C's. Is there any relation between C's and T's? No, no. So this is not following. Next. Some C's are T's. This is also not following. When you take here the diagram, it will follow. This is not following. So again, there might be one more diagram. Like that, if there are 10 diagrams, in at least one of the diagram, if this doesn't follow, then you should put false. When you consider more and more alternative diagrams, instead of checking all the alternative diagrams, what I want to do is, I want you people to take relation only for the given things. Okay, so don't form unnecessary relations. Then you should check all the alternative diagrams. Instead of that, just form for this and then see whether they are following or not. So none follows. Both 1 and 2 do not follow for this. Okay. Next. All digits are symbols. So all digits are symbols. Next. All symbols are letters. So now all symbols are letters. Some letters are elements. Some letters are elements. See, only for this. This can be drawn like this also. But he gave relation between letters and elements only. So for letters and elements only I am taking. So now all digits are letters. Is it correct? All digits are letters. Am I correct? So this is following. Next. Some symbols are elements. Is there any relation between symbol and element? No. Next. All letters are digits. Is all letters digits? No, no. Some letters are digits. But all digits are letters. So this is also not following. So only one follows. Okay. You copy. So we'll go for next slide. So I want you people to solve from next. Next. So you solve this until. So now we will go for. Now once listen to Saras before you come back to this. We have no cases, sir. Okay. See. So now coming to this, all order are sore, he told. All order are sore. Next. No sore is sweet. No sore is sweet means, sir. So this is sweet. So this is sore. So listen here once. See, this can be drawn like this also. One, see. So, all udder are sore. Udder, sore. So, no udder is sweet means, I can take here also. This is udder, no. No udder is sweet. So, I can take like this also, no. Am I correct? Or else I can take like this also, no. Udder, sore. Can I take like this also? So there are many alternative diagrams. Now we, till earlier question, we don't have any negative conclusions. Here we didn't have any negative conclusions. But for this also we didn't have any negative conclusions. Both are positive conclusions only. Now once see here, do we have negative conclusions or not? Some not. We saw only some. Now we are seeing some not. When you have some not, this is a negative word. So, negative conclusion. No order is sweet. This is also a negative conclusion. So, when you get negative conclusion, our target is that we want to prove that it is wrong. Negative one is wrong, we should prove. We should try to prove that. See, generally what we were doing till earlier one, if only positive are there, so we will be taking, or else I will come back to that again. So now once see here, some udder are not sweet. Some udder are not sweet means, generally if you see here what is happening, some udder are not sweet. Am I correct? Some udder are not sweet. This is becoming true. So conclusion is negative and it is becoming true. When negative becomes true, we should try to prove that it is wrong. Okay, so when negative is becoming true, then go for alternative diagram. See, with positive, we don't have any problem. If positive is true, we'll say that the conclusion is following. If positive is not following, then we'll say that it is not following. When positive is wrong, we say that it is not following. No problem with positive conclusions. When you come for negative conclusions, we should try to prove that it is wrong. When it becomes true, we'll go for alternative diagram. There are many alternative diagrams. I don't know, this can be drawn like this. Order, sore, and then sweet. This is one we drew. Next, order, sore, sweet. This also we can draw for this. See, this is not, this is following this. These statements, this is following. See, all udder are sore. Next, no sore is sweet. Sorry, no sore is sweet. So, no sore is sweet. Oh, we'll come back again. So, no sore is sweet. Okay. We'll come back. So, now what is the alternative diagram means? So, alternative for some not, we should take it as all. See, what is a some not and all? See, what does it mean? Some not means, see, if I prove that opposite, exact opposite of, you are attending the class. What is exact opposite of that? You are not attending the class. If I prove that, when some people are saying that you are not attending the class, if I prove that you are attending the class, which is exactly opposite of that, it means that the earlier word which he told is wrong. Am I correct? So if some people say that I am not teaching the class, so I will prove that I am teaching the class, which is exactly opposite of that, then that word, that conclusion which that fellow gave will become wrong. When I prove that exactly opposite of that is true. In the same way, some not exact opposite is all. Instead of taking irrespective number of alternative diagrams, I will take only one alternative diagram which is exactly opposite of this one. So, some not exact opposite is all. So, now what I will do now? For this, I will try to draw the diagram. See, again I am telling you, so if negative conclusion becomes true, don't get confused, I will give you a chart again. If negative conclusion becomes true, then we will try to go for alternative diagram. So what I want to do is, see, there are two types of conclusions. Conclusions are of two types. One is positive and another is negative. So, if positive becomes true, then conclusion follows. We'll directly put away, conclusion follows. If past two does not follow, we'll tell conclusion do not follow. We'll put away do not follow. Okay, no problem with positive ones. When positive doesn't follow, negative doesn't follow, we'll put away conclusion do not follow. No problem when it becomes negative. So conclusion do not follow. When negative becomes true only, our problem starts. So we want to show that this negative is not true always. So in that case, I'll go for alternative diagram. So we'll be going for alternate. If negative becomes true, then we'll go for alternative diagram. So alternative diagram means for sum not, we are going to take all. Exact opposite of sum not is all. Okay, for no is also negative only. No, for no we are going to take sum. Exact opposite of no is sum. Okay, so if alternative becomes true, then if this is becoming true, opposite of this is becoming true means conclusion do not follow. Don't get confused, understand clearly. Again I'll come back to the problem. Conclusion do not follow. If alternative becomes wrong, exact opposite of this is becoming wrong, it means that this is true. So conclusion follows. Conclusion is following. So what is this? If negative conclusion is there, if that becomes wrong, no problem, conclusion do not follow. When that becomes true, then we should go for alternative. Alternative diagram we'll take and we'll check from that. We'll go back to conclusions. I'll explain that in the problem. If alternative is becoming true, then conclusion do not follow. If this becomes true, no, conclusion opposite of this is becoming true. So this should become wrong. No, conclusion should become wrong. In the same way, if alternative do not follow, then conclusion follow. When opposite of this is not following, it means that this is true. Okay, conclusion follows. As of now, you copy this, I'll come back to problem again. Okay, now we'll come back. We'll come back to the question. Now let's see. Again, I'll tell clearly. So this is the diagram for the given statements. Now we are seeing whether this conclusion is positive or negative. This is negative conclusion. Negative conclusion is becoming true. When negative becomes true, what we should do? We should go for alternative diagram. What is alternative for sum not? Alternative for sum not is all. For sum not, we should take all. This is the alternative for sum not. So it means that this conclusion can be, for opposite of that will be all other are sweet. Alternative of that is all other are sweet. So now what we do is that for this you try to draw the diagram. Now earlier we are seeing the diagram for statements. Now we are seeing the diagram for this alternative. So all other are sweet. All other are sweet. So all other are sweet. So for this I wrote no remaining thing. However, here it is there like that only you represent. Okay. Here it is like all other are sour. No. See, again I will be drawing here. How I am drawing? Here for this we will draw the diagram now. What is this? All other are sweet. Other. All other are sweet. So now remaining thing, however it is there in the statement diagram, that only you represent. So now this is sour. So now for this you see whether these statements are following. So we should prove that this alternative diagram is, we should check whether this alternative is true or not now. So when alternative is true or not, we should check means we should go for the statements and see whether this is following the statements or not. Okay, now all other are sour. All other are sour, satisfied. So statement one, it is following this alternative diagram. Next, no sour is sweet. But see here, some sour are sweet. So no sour is sweet should be followed. But this is not following that now. Statement 2 also it is not following. When this doesn't follow at least one of the statements, it means that alternative is not following. Alternative is not following. When alternative doesn't follow, it means that conclusion follows. Conclusion is following. That is what I told here. See, so what did I tell you here? When I check alternative, if alternative follows, it means that this alternative diagram should follow all the statements, should satisfy all the statements. Then it means conclusion do not follow. When this doesn't follow all the statements, it doesn't satisfy all the statements, then it is wrong. When it doesn't follow those, then conclusion follows. Okay, so I'll tell you one more. So it means that this is following. Now we will see this also, then you can come to a conclusion. I'll give you one more problem also, no problem. So no other is a sweet, he told. So no other is a sweet, this is negative, no. So negative, is it becoming true or not? See here. So no other is sweet, negative is becoming true. When negative becomes true, what we'll do? We'll go for alternative. When you go for alternative, so what is alternative of no? So for alternative of no is sum. Alternative of no is sum. So for this, can I say that alternative will be sum no or so alternative will be some other or sweet. Some other or sweet. Alternative will be some other or sweet. So now what we will do, we will draw diagram for this. We are seeing that negative is true, then I went for alternative. Alternative is some other or sweet. So some other or sweet means other, this is sweet. Then what is that remaining thing, however, is there here, like that only we will draw away. So what is this? That's all. So now this is so. So now for this we will see statements. All other are sour. So all other are sour. It is satisfying. Statement 1, it is following. Next. No sour is sweet. But see here, some sour are sweet. So statement 2, it is not following. So when it doesn't follow at least one statement, it means that alternative is not following. When alternative do not follow, what happens to conclusion? Conclusion becomes true. So it means that this is true. Okay, again we can come back to this. I'll give you one more question and then we'll come back to that. Okay, now this, don't write anything, just see. Hope you have learned something today. If you like the lecture, subscribe to the channel. If you have any doubts, you can ask them in the comment section. Give your valuable feedback in the comment section. For complete lectures of mine, enroll in Octomy. Thank you. Let's catch up in Octomy.